Hey everyone, it's Lydia. So today's video, I'm gonna be talking about, it's gonna be like a letter writing to the future me in 1 year time. Talking to myself when I'm 27, because I'm 26 now. So I'm just gonna get straight to it. I wrote it down, I don't know if I showed you already, on Word document. Oh, wow. Dear you, you are 26 years old and started working in a house cleaning company called and you are currently on training. The people you work with are beautiful. You are also studying Certificate 3 in Event Management, but online because your working hours is affecting the time that you have class time. You just got your provisional license too, which is Green Peas. This is only in Australia. I don't know about other countries, but in Australia for driver's license, you have 4 stages. So learners, provisional license 1, provisional license 2, and then full license. So I'm up to the 3rd stage. And you still have your first car, which is Holden Barina. You have gone through a lot in life since you can remember from a young age. From experiencing emotional neglect, emotional abuse, and being judged on as well. From all these, you have come out stronger than ever. But sometimes you probably forget that, and that's okay. You still have your days of struggle now and then, but you are one strong woman that I know. Even though no one knows exactly your position, except Father in Heaven knows that. You are currently living in Sydney and in a share house. However, at the moment you are moving out to move to a different share house. In the same city though. You accepted Jesus into your life in January 2017. Since that day, your life changed. Best ever decision in your life. You love Jesus dearly because sometimes you struggle to create a routine to spend more time with him on a daily basis. You have a beautiful family of mom and dad and 3 brothers who loves you dearly. You are absolutely close with them, and I would say in absolute honesty, you're blessed to have a relationship with all of them because there are families out there that doesn't have that. Be thankful to Jesus for them every day. You have a boyfriend for over a year now, and I hope you are still with him because he is definitely a keeper. You have both gone through a lot of hurt and pain growing up in your own families. You both have made such a great positive impact in each other's lives. He is the most understanding, patient, loving, funny, weird, non-judgment, encourages you in following Jesus in many different ways. Kindness would do anything for you, and you both would do anything for each other, and 100% supportive towards each other. You have the most beautiful friends that doesn't judge you, are there for you when you need them, literally, that Jesus has placed in your life. Please remember that you have a beautiful heart, so kind, loving, understanding, funny, and don't worry about those that judge you in your decisions in life. You just started talking to your boyfriend's sister a few weeks ago, and she's the only one from your boyfriend's family that you have a relationship with and close to. You both have common things in life, have gone through somewhat similar experiences in life. She's like a sister you never had, literally. And also, just a note, I got to put this in, but she's the only one that I'm close to and have a relationship with because, how do I say this? Because she's the only one that knows how to speak English because she lives in UK, and she's the only sister as well that lives in UK and knows how to speak English. But the rest of my boyfriend's sisters, because he has more than one sister, the rest live in back in Iran, but they don't speak English there. They speak in their language. You have accomplished to finally move out of mom and dad's place towards the end of last year. You bought your first car with your own money. You worked hard to get your driver's license because I was on my L's for like more than 5 years, on and off. Sometimes I didn't even drive for like months, which is bad. And you have a job that you truly enjoy from the bottom of your heart. Remember, you are always faithfully loved by Jesus. That's all I have for today's video. Thank you so much for watching this. And I will see you guys in my next new video. Okay. Bye guys!